from this boat. Mark 4, in verse, starting in verse 35, we just left Capernaum. That's Mark 1, 2, and 3, from what I understand. Jesus healed the man with the withered hand, the synagogue. He at the beginning of chapter 4, he tells the several parables, the sower. But then it says in verse 35, on that day when evening had come, Jesus said to them, let us go to the other side. And leaving the crowd, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. And a great storm of wind arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already filling. So imagine, on this water, a great storm arose, and the waves crashing into the boat. And then it says in verse 38, but he was in the stern asleep. Somewhere around that part of the boat, I presume, right? The stern of the boat. Yes, sir. He would be in the boat asleep on the cushion. The disciples are freaking out. Jesus is asleep. And they woke him and said to him, teacher, do you care if we perish? And I just want to stop there, because here's basically the thought that I had in my mind. The disciples are in the midst of the storm, and they literally think the boat is about to go down. Storms. I mean, it's a great analogy to life, storms of life. I mean, think of COVID. We should have been here a year and a half ago, but a storm came. Think of the airport yesterday. A storm. Paris.
Yeah.
A storm. And just a little bit ago, another storm blew over. And we're so tempted, when storms come, the first thing we ask Jesus to do is stop the storm. Yes. Stop the storm. Stop the storm. Why is this? Stop the storm. We're so focused on stopping the storm, but sometimes God just allows storms to happen. You know, the thing that really caught my attention is Jesus said, on that day when evening had come, he said to them, let us go across to the other side. Jesus said, we're going to the other side, but yet the disciples doubted his word when the storms came. And that's just like us, isn't it? Jesus gives us a promise. We have a word. We're going to the other side. We're going to make it. You know, you're going to come forth as gold, but we doubt the word of Jesus. But then he says, and he in verse 39, and he awoke and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, peace be still. Now we get so focused on he rebuked the wind, the peace be still. Peace be still. What a wonderful miracle. But I don't think, I think in this instance, I think the miracle is not so much as Jesus calming the wind, but I think it's the miracle, what he's trying to do in the disciples' heart, because he says, and the wind ceased and there was a great calm. And then he said to them, why were you afraid? Have you no faith? And they were filled with awe and said to one another. Usually when we're preaching this or teaching this, it's all about, look, Jesus calmed the storm. Jesus calmed the storm. Look at the miracle. But I think we need to just keep reading. Where's your faith? Where's your faith? The point is, it's not about the absence of the storms. It's not about Jesus calming every storm. Sometimes he just don't calm every storm of life. The most important thing that I take from this, Jesus is in the boat. Jesus said we're going to the other side. And as long as Jesus is in the boat's not going down. It doesn't matter suppose he didn't calm the sea. The boat's still not going down, is it? Because Jesus said. So it's not about the absence of the storm. It's about the presence of Jesus in the midst of the storm. In the midst of whatever we're going through. And talk about stories. He said these snapshots of, you take these shots. I mean, that's the souvenir. Think of everything that, as we process, as Dad said, as we process everything, we're probably going to look back on this, and we're just going to have a story of the presence of Jesus and how we've experienced the presence of Jesus. So my prayer throughout this trip, and as I laid awake for probably 4 hours, waking up at like 1 o'clock and just laying there, I literally was praying. I just want to grow closer to you. I want to sense your presence. I got a lot of storms I wish Jesus would take care of. But whether he takes care of them or not, If I've got his presence, I'm good. Yes. And it's the same thing with everybody here. You've got his presence. The boat is not going down. The boat's not going down. You've got his, hold to his presence. Better is one day in his house. We have the house of God with us all the time. The presence of God with us all the time. That's all we could ask for. Amen.